Scanning barcodes cannot be easier with the CLICK PLC. In this video, I'll show you just how easy it is. Step 1. I've got an RS232 scanner, so I'll plug the scanner into port 2 on my PLC. Step 2. We need to configure port 2. To do that, go to Setup, and then COM port Setup. We need to set up port 2, so go ahead and choose that. Port 2 defaults to Modbus RTU, but we want to read ASCII, so choose the ASCII protocol. Be careful, don't forget to do that one. This particular scanner operates at 9600 baud, odd parity, 1 stop bit, and 8 communication data bits. Click OK to exit port 2 setup, and then go ahead and close out of the COM port setup. Step 3. Read the barcode. Bring in a receive command. Double check that port 2 is selected. We'll be reading a fixed data length of 10 characters long. You'll understand why in just a minute. The data destination is where to store the string that you receive from the scanner. You can choose any text address that you like. I'll go ahead and choose text 1. The status flags help show the condition of the command. You can choose any C address you'd like. I'm going to go ahead and set receiving as C1, success as C2, and overflow as C3. We didn't set any timeout, so you can leave first character timeout and character interval timeout blank. When you're done entering everything, you can go ahead and hit OK. Add a normally open contact on the first rung, and type in C4. Don't forget to add your end statement. Step 4. Transfer your program to the PLC. And that's it. Step 1, we plugged our scanner in. Step 2, we configured our serial port. Step 3, we configured an ASCII receive command. And step 4, we transferred our program to the PLC. I don't think you can get it any easier than that. To read a barcode, open up a data view window and type in C4. Then click on Edit. This will let us toggle C4 on and off, which is controlling our receive command. Turn C4 on by double-clicking the On button. Now we can scan a barcode and see it here. Here we can see a 10-character string read from the barcode scanner. The string is stored in text 1 through text 10. For our example, S is stored in text 1, M is stored in text 2, and so on. You can now use these values elsewhere in your ladder logic program. If you want to scan another barcode, all you have to do is turn C4 off and then back on. And sure enough, we can see a different barcode here. Now that you know how to set up and use a barcode scanner with the CLICK PLC, the possibilities are endless.